Let us continue boron family elements. In that, let us see extraction of boron from borax. Now we will take borax. Borax will take Na2B4O7. It is treated with a concentrated HCl, otherwise concentrated sulfuric acid. We are getting a tetraboric acid, H2B4O7. This H2B4O7 undergoes hydrolysis to give H3BO3, orthoboric acid. This orthoboric acid on strong heating gives B2O3. This B2O3 undergoes a reduction with the sodium or potassium or magnesium to give boron. So now we will take this tetraboric acid we will take. How this tetraboric acid will be there, that we will write. Tetraboric acid in which 4 boron atoms are there, those 4 boron atoms will write like this. Then we will give oxygen bridges. Oxygen bridges. Then we will give 2 OH groups. It is called a tetraboric acid. This tetraboric acid is this one. Okay. This undergoes hydrolysis to give orthoboric acid. How it is giving, that we will see. Now we will take this one. This boron comes under second period. Second period means it is having 2s and 2p orbitals. This boron is having 2s and 2p orbitals. This boron is having 2s and 2p orbitals. Now, this boron is surrounded by 3 bonds. That means it is having one vacant orbital. It is having vacant orbital. Then it is undergoing hydrolysis, means water molecule comes like this. This water molecule contains a central atom oxygen that is having lone pair. Now this oxygen is attacking this boron. Here oxygen is contributor of lone pair. Boron is contributing vacant orbital. Between boron and oxygen, dative bond is possible. So between boron and oxygen, dative bond is possible. In this dative bond, oxygen has contributed lone pair, boron has contributed vacant orbital. Now we will write this dative bond as a normal covalent bond by giving formal charges. Okay. This dative bond we have written as normal covalent bond. Now we will give formal charges for oxygen plus 1, for boron minus 1. Now, next point we'll see. Here, this oxygen is having 2 lone pairs. This is having positive charge, therefore this bond is shifting towards oxygen. This hydrogen is losing the electron, therefore it is getting positive charge. This H plus will attack, it will go to here, this place. This oxygen will contribute lone pair to this. This hydrogen loses the bond. This hydrogen loses the electron, therefore it gets positive charge. Therefore it is having vacant orbital. Now this oxygen is contributing lone pair to this vacant orbital. Therefore between this oxygen and this hydrogen, dative bond is possible. Okay. Now this bond is migrating to this oxygen. Therefore positive charge vanishes. So here positive charge is vanishing. This bond is shifting to oxygen. Between this hydrogen and this oxygen, dative bond is possible. Okay. So this oxygen gets a lone pair. Between this oxygen and hydrogen, dative bond is possible. This hydrogen is having plus charge because it has lost electron from this oxygen. Sir, this dative bond, we will write it as normal covalent bond by giving formal charges. For oxygen, you give minus 1. For for oxygen you have to give plus 1 because donor. For hydrogen you have to give minus 1, already plus 1 is there, therefore 0. So this dative bond we will write it as normal covalent bond. For oxygen we have given plus 1. Okay, so why we have given oxygen plus 1 in the sense, because it has contributed electron pair. Next, water molecule. Now we will take another water molecule like this. In this water molecule oxygen is having 2 lone pairs. Now this oxygen is contributing lone pair to this boron. So between this oxygen and this boron, dative bond is possible. So we will write a dative bond like this. Here boron is acceptor, oxygen is contributor. This dative bond will write it as normal covalent bond here. Now we will give formal charge here plus 1, here minus 1 we will give. Next step. Next step we will take. Next step is this is having positive charge, so that we will shift the bond towards oxygen. Therefore hydrogen gets positive charge, therefore it is having vacant orbital. Now this oxygen is contributing lone pair to this. We need not take this oxygen, we can take this oxygen also. Okay, so any oxygen we can take, either this oxygen or this oxygen, any oxygen you can take. And also we have to shift this bond. Okay, we have to shift this bond. We are shifting this bond because it is having positive charge, it is having negative charge. It is having minus 1, it is having plus 1. Therefore, we can shift this bond this side. Okay, so one point we are shifting this bond this side. Therefore, plus 1 vanishes, minus 1 vanishes. This bond will shift towards oxygen. Therefore, plus 1 vanishes. This hydrogen making bond with this oxygen. Okay, let us shift this bond towards oxygen. Therefore, plus 1 vanishes. This minus 1 vanishes. This bond will let us shift to oxygen. This plus 1 vanishes. This hydrogen will make a bond, dative bond with this oxygen. So now it is getting lone pair. Therefore plus 1 vanishes. It is getting lone pair. So plus 1 vanishes. It has lost bond. Therefore minus 1 lattices. It is losing minus 1. Here dative bond we are writing. Okay. Now this dative bond will write it as normal covalent bond, while it will get plus 1, it will get what in the sense, zero charge. So it is getting plus 1. Okay, it is getting zero charge. Then next, it is making water molecule now. It is making a next point we'll see. Here plus 1 is there, here minus 1 is there. Here this oxygen is having plus 1, this boron is having minus 1. Therefore this bond is migrating towards oxygen. Okay, this bond is migrating towards oxygen. Therefore plus 1 vanishes, this oxygen gets a lone pair. Now this minus 1 vanishes. Now you say, what is this one? You say, is it detached from tetraboric acid? This part, is it detached from tetraboric acid? That means this tetraboric acid, this tetraboric acid on hydrolysis results this one. What is this one you say? This is called orthoboric acid. This is called orthoboric acid. So we got what in the sense, orthoboric acid we got. We got orthoboric acid, H3BO3. H3BO3 orthoboric acid we got. Okay, next. So tetraboric acid on hydrolysis gives orthoboric acid. Sorry. Next, orthoboric acid. This orthoboric acid we have written here, H3BO3. This orthoboric acid on strong heating gives B2O3. How it is giving B2O3? That we will see. Now we'll write another orthoboric acid. we'll take another orthoboric acid. Okay. Now, we'll round off what in the sense water molecules we have to round off. Let us round off water molecules. Okay. One water molecule we have rounded off. Let us round off next water molecule. Next water molecule. This oxygen takes the bond. This hydrogen loses the bond like that. Okay. Next, we'll take like this. Okay. So how many water molecules you see? We have taken two boric acids, two orthoboric acids. On strong heating, what happens? Three water molecules have been eliminated. Okay. Water molecules are eliminating. Okay. Let us remove the water molecules. We have removed the water molecules. Yes. So, what will happen? We'll see here. This oxygen is having negative charge. It is having 3 lone pairs. This oxygen is having negative charge. It is having 3 lone pairs. This oxygen is having negative charge. It is having 3 lone pairs. So now, what will happen? We'll see. This negative charge will shift to here. This negative charge will shift to here. This lone pair will shift to this place. So that what we will get here, see, this oxygen, this single bond becomes a double bond, this boron, this oxygen, this boron, this oxygen. Okay. So we got B2O3, we got which one in the sense, B2O3. This B2O3, what is this name? Boron. Boron is there. Therefore, boron, we will say boron. Three oxygens are there. Therefore, trioxide. Three oxygens. Therefore, we will say trioxide, we will say. So, this name is boron trioxide. Then, this is from this boric acid. From this boric you take. Boric. Then, this O we will say as oxide. Boric oxide. Then we'll say this boric word we'll take. Boric word we'll take. This we have got. This we have got from this one. This loses water molecules and gives this one. Therefore, this is a anhydride of this one. So that we can say boric anhydride. So this B2O3 we can call it as a This is boric anhydride, we can say. This is from this one. Therefore, it is called boric anhydride. So, this is boric anhydride or boron trioxide or boric oxide. Like this, we can say. Next, this boric anhydride undergoes reduction to give boron. What is a reducing agent is used here? Reducing agent is sodium or potassium or magnesium. Here. This boron oxidation number is +3. It is converting into boron. So reduction. Here sodium. Sodium is converting into Na+ by losing electron. This electron is taken by this boron and becomes like this. This B3+ undergoes reduction. Sodium undergoes oxidation. This sodium takes this oxygen and becomes what means sodium oxide. So, this B2O3 is converting into boron. Sodium is converting into sodium oxide. If you use potassium, we'll get potassium oxide. If you use magnesium, we'll get magnesium oxide. If you use sodium, sodium oxide, potassium, potassium oxide, magnesium oxide, we will get. So B2O3 is converted into what in the sense boron? This B2O3 is converted into what in the sense boron? Here, what is the reducing agent we are using? Means sodium or potassium or magnesium is the reducing agent we are using. So, this is the method of extraction of boron from what in the sense borax. Now we will write balanced equations of this one. Balanced equations we will write. Borax is Na2B4O7. Corn HCl we can take. We are getting tetraboric acid H2B4O7. Sodium is converting into sodium chloride. In the place of HCl, we can use sulfuric acid. Corn sulfuric acid we can use. In the place of HCl, we have used corn sulfuric acid. So borax Na2B4O7, corn sulfuric acid gives tetraboric acid H2B4O7. This sodium and sulfate becomes sodium sulfate. This sodium and this sulfate becomes sodium sulfate. Then this tetraboric acid will take H2B4O7. This on hydrolysis, this undergoes hydrolysis to give what in the sense orthoboric acid H3BO3. Here boron is 4 times, so we'll write 4 times. Hydrogen is 4, 3 is 12. 12 hydrogens are there. Here 2 hydrogens are there. Therefore, we can write 6 water molecules we'll write. 12, here 12 hydrogens, therefore 5 water molecules will write. Oxygen will take, here 5 threes are 12, here 7, here 5, 12 oxygens, okay. Next step, this orthoboric acid on strong heating gives B2O3. Here 2 times boric acid, 3 times water molecules will write. This boric oxide B2O3, is treated with the sodium, it gives boron and sodium becomes sodium oxide. Sodium will take 2 times, boron like this. So oxygen, you see that how many times we are getting, you see 3 oxygens are there, so we will take 3 oxygen. Sodium we will make 6. Sodium we are making 6 times we are making. 6 times sodium. Sorry. In the place of sodium, we can use even potassium or even magnesium we can use. Okay. Next, we'll see how to extract boron from colemanite ore. From colemanite ore, how to extract boron, that we'll see. Now we will take colemanite. Colemanite formula Ca2B6O11. Colemanite formula Ca2B6O11. To this, let us add sodium carbonate. And we will heat the contents. Let us fuse them. Fusing them. So what we will get? This calcium takes carbonate and becomes calcium carbonate. Sodium, boron, oxygen becomes what in the sense? One is borax, Na2B4O7. Another one is sodium metaborate, NaBO2. So this colemanite on fusing with the sodium carbonate, we are getting calcium carbonate, borax, Na2B4O7, and sodium metaborate we are getting. To this mixture, we are adding water. And we are dissolving all the contents and we are filtering. On filtration, we are getting 2 things. On filtration, we are getting 2 things. One is filtrate. Another one is residue. Filtrate we are getting, then residue we are getting. Residue contains what means calcium carbonate. This calcium carbonate goes to the residue. All the metal carbonates are insoluble in water except sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium carbonate. This borax and sodium metaborate goes to the filtrate. Borax and sodium metaborate. Borax is Na2B4O7, sodium metaborate is NaBO2, goes to the filtrate. This is taken for crystallization now. It is taken for crystallization. On crystallization, borax will become crystals. Borax will become crystals. And sodium metaborate goes to solution. Sodium metaborate goes to solution. Sorry. Now, to this sodium metaborate, to this sodium metaborate, carbon dioxide gas is passed. On passing carbon dioxide gas, this borax is converting into borax. So, the sodium metaborate with the carbon dioxide gives a borax, Na2B4O7. From borax, we can know how to extract boron. That means just before method. That method we can follow to get a boron. So, we are fusing colmonite with sodium carbonate and we are getting a borax. From borax, we can extract boron by previous method. So, we can extract boron from colmonite in this way. There is another way of extracting boron from colmonite. That way we will see. Colmonite will take Ca2B6O11. To this we will pass a sulfur dioxide gas by keeping colmonite in the suspension of water. So we are passing sulfur dioxide gas into the suspension of colmonite in water. So what we are getting? One is a calcium becomes calcium bisulfite. Boron becomes orthoboric acid. From orthoboric acid, we know how to extract boron as like the first method. Now, this equation we will balance. Calcium is 2 times in the colmonite. So, calcium bisulfite will take 2 times. Then, boron is 6 times in the colmonite. So, orthoboric acid will take 6 times. Then, sulfur is 4 times here. In calcium bisulfite, sulfur is 4 times present. Therefore, 4 sulfur dioxide will take. Remaining is, we can balance it. So, we will take water molecules 11. So, in the suspension of colmonite, we are passing sulfur dioxide gas. We are getting orthoboric acid. From orthoboric acid, we know how to extract boron. Sorry. In this way, we are extracting boron. Next, physical properties of boron, we'll see. Boron is an extremely hard substance. Refractory solid in the sense, it can withstand high temperature, that is called a refractory solid. Then it has high melting point, it is having low density, it is having very low electrical conductivity. Electrical conductivity is very low. Then in the boron, 2 allotropes are possible. One is crystalline boron, another one is amorphous boron. So, how to draw crystalline boron, that we will see. Crystalline boron. Now we will take, to draw crystalline boron, we will take one boron atom here. Second boron atom, third boron atom, fourth boron atom, fifth boron atom. 5 boron atoms you have taken like this. Then 5 more boron atoms you will take. Here 1 boron atom, this 1 boron atom, here 1 boron atom. Here 1 boron atom. Here 1 boron atom. So we have taken like this. Now we'll join this boron and this boron. Next, Next, we'll join this boron atom and this boron atom. Next, this boron atom and this boron atom will join. Next, we'll join this boron atom and this boron atom. Next, these two boron atoms we have joined. Next, these two boron atoms we have joined. Next, let us join the boron atoms here. Let us join the boron atoms. Next, we'll join the boron atoms. Here also we'll join the boron atoms. Okay. Here 5 boron atoms, here 5 boron atoms. Totally 10 boron atoms we have written here. Next, let us take one boron atom here. Let us take one boron atom here. So totally we have taken 12 boron atoms we have taken. Totally how many boron atoms we have taken means 12 boron atoms we have taken. Next. Next, we'll see, we are joining the boron atoms now. Let us join this boron atom. Then we have joined. We got a triangle now. We have joined the boron atoms. We got a one triangle. Next, we'll join. We got here another triangle. Next. We have joined the boron atoms. We got a triangle. Here we have joined the boron atoms, we got a triangle. So how many triangles we got, you see that? Have we got totally 5 triangles? Okay. In the same way we'll do here. It is one line. Next, we'll go like this. It is one triangle. Here one triangle we got. Here one triangle we got. Here one triangle. Here one triangle. So totally we got five triangles we got. Down five triangles, up five triangles we got. Next. Next triangles we will draw. Now, let us join this boron. This one triangle. Now we got second triangle. We got second triangle. We are drawing next triangle. Third triangle we have drawn. Next, fourth triangle. Fifth triangle. Sixth triangle. Next, seventh triangle. This is not triangle. This is one triangle. Next. This one triangle. Next. This one triangle. Next. This one triangle. So totally we got 10 triangles here. In this round 10 triangles. So above 5 triangles, below 5 triangles, totally if you see 20 triangles we got. Now we'll do again. This is what. It is second. This is third. This fourth. This is fifth. This is sixth. This is seventh. This is eighth. This eighth. This is ninth. This is tenth. So here 10 triangles, here five, totally 20. So 20 in the sense that we can say icosahedron. Icosahedron. Icosa means 20. Icosa means 12 boron atoms. Here 20 equivalent triangles. This is called icosahedron, we can say. So crystalline boron is called icosahedron structure. Now we will see crystalline boron, amorphous boron chemical properties. We will see in the chemical properties. Crystalline boron is unreactive in air. Crystalline boron is not reacting with air, but amorphous boron on burning, on heating with air, it is giving what we will see. Amorphous boron with oxygen gives B2O3. Amorphous boron with oxygen gives B2O3. Boron is converting into plus 3. Oxygen is converting into minus 2. Cross multiply, you will get B2O3. Then boron, amorphous boron burning with nitrogen to give boron nitride. Boron is converting into B plus 3. Nitrogen is converting into 3 minus. Therefore, we are getting BN. This BN is called boron nitride. This BN is called boron nitride. This BN name is called boron nitride, we can say. Now, this boron nitride structure is similar like graphite. This boron nitride structure is similar like graphite structure. Okay. Next, we'll take hot boron. We'll take that. We'll treat with the steam. We'll take hot boron. That we'll treat with the steam. That we'll treat with the steam. What we'll get, we'll see. Boron is converting into B2O3, and hydrogen gas is liberated. That means boron is converted into plus 3. Boron undergoes oxidation. This hydrogen oxidation number is plus 1. Hydrogen undergoes reduction. Hydrogen plus 1 is converting into 0. So hydrogen undergoes reduction. Boron is converting into plus 3. Oxidation. This oxygen is having 2 minus charge. Cross multiply, you will get B2O3. So hot boron with the steam. Hot boron with the steam, we are getting B2O3 and hydrogen gas. Sorry. Next. Boron is not reacting with the non-oxidizing acids. Non-oxidizing acids. Non-oxidizing acids. Which are non-oxidizing acids? One is a dilute HCl. Next one is corn HCl. Next one is a dilute sulfuric acid. These are non-oxidizing acids. Boron is not reacting with non-oxidizing acids. Boron is not reacting with this because these are not oxidizing agents. So boron is not reacting with this. But boron is reacting with oxidizing acids. Oxidizing acids. Oxidizing acids means they act as oxidizing agents. Nitric acid and corn sulfuric acid. Corn sulfuric acid. So now we will take boron and hot concentrated sulfuric acid. We will take hot concentrated sulfuric acid. So here, what is the product obtained? Product is H3BO3 and sulfur dioxide. Boron is converted into B3 plus. Therefore, we are getting orthoboric acid. Sulfur plus 6 is converting into sulfur plus 4, that is sulfur dioxide. Sulfur plus 6 is converted into sulfur plus 4, that is sulfur dioxide. Boron converting into B3 plus, that is orthoboric acid. Let us write balanced equation.